Alors, bonjour à tous, j'espère que vous allez bien. Hello everybody, so this one will be in English because it's for beginners. Let's have a look at, well, the persons who are here, because we want to be polite and salute everybody. Edgley is with us, Evelyn is here too, Anna, bonjour, Gloria est là, Luciana Moribé, coucou, Yossi, bonjour monsieur, Luciana, ah oui, just said it, hein. Cosmina est là, Victoria Posse, bonjour. Anna, Lynn est avec nous, Shahi, bonjour, Victoria Jacques, coucou, Jessiard, or should I say Imane, I don't really know which one I should use, Jessiard or Imane, tell me exactly, or then should I pronounce it, Xiar, I don't know, you should help me, Annabelle, bonjour, Denora est là, Hilary aussi, Andrea, coucou, Strange73 est là aussi, je vois que Cheryline est là, Cheryl est là aussi, Fiona, coucou, comment ça va? Il y a toujours, toujours mes fleurs derrière, Dishan TV, Emma est là aussi, everybody is here, Sophia X, Sophia, you saw the skiing thing, well it was not skiing, it was snowboarding, but this is what you can have as landscapes in Lapland, it was just to show you that. And Julia said, do you still have videos with Laurent when you were doing the gestures? Yes. Yes, I will do some exercises with them. I was thinking about that. The snowboard, yes, it's with the GoPro and it's in Lapland. But it was only Lolo and Alex. Laurent et Alex, my good friends. Allez, on peut commencer si vous voulez bien. Let's start. So let's not forget, and let's not forget the objective as far as I am concerned is to reach the 100 likes, so it would be nice, merci. Alors, as usual, I try to give you some tips and recommendations. So today I wanted to, well, give you a tip for a book if you really want. In fact, I was talking about that yesterday, not yesterday, but 2 days ago, when somebody was asking what books I could recommend or what author I could recommend. I think, and I told you that Fred Vargas, when it comes to Well, this kind of criminal things, I think it's quite good. She's really a good writer, and probably you should start with the first one because she's been writing several. But then each time you start to meet again some characters, so it's quite important to start with the first one. Debout les morts, it's a really, really good book. I think it's not too difficult in terms of language, so it could be a good thing that you could probably start to read and to work on. It's been translated, by the way, in English, so if you really want to work on the two versions at the same time, it is possible. The song of the day, it's an old one. It's an old one, but I love it so much. It's from 85. I think it's one of the most popular songs that French people, usually name when they're asked for a song that they really like. So, Renaud, Mistral Gagnant would be the song that I would invite you to listen to and look at the lyrics. It's quite interesting because he's talking about the childhood and his childhood with memories and things like that. It's really, really nice. Voilà! Let's start with the question of the day, because yesterday it was the only day when we were not together. So what did you do yesterday? Qu'est-ce que vous avez fait hier? Tanej joining us. Bonjour Tanej. Andrea, j'adore Renaud. Moi aussi. Moi aussi, Andrea, j'adore Renaud. He used to be a really great singer that I was listening to when I was young. Alors, je ne sais pas, is it the first one? I'm not really sure. I mean, Strange 73, you're writing, merci, j'aime le lit. Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Andrea qui nous dit, so je suis allé en vélo, très bien. Olga, bonsoir. Olga, you can join the lesson. Don't forget to write the sentence. The question is, what did you do yesterday? Umila, it's the same thing. Bonsoir, don't forget, write it. Edgley, you should write in French. This is the concept. Get real, vous désirez autre chose? Non, merci. Alors, Strange 73, j'ai travaillé. Don't forget to put that in the passé composé form, because basically I'm asking you to describe what you've been doing yesterday. So, travailler, regular verb, first group. You need to use avoir as the helping verb, and then after that you will put the past participle. Avoir should be in the present. J'ai. Hein, J'AI, and then travailler with the accent and not ER. Gloria, j'ai fait une randonnée au parc Tilden en Californie. Je ne sais pas quel est ce parc. Est-ce qu'il est beau, Gloria? Victoria, je suis allée à l'épicerie. Oui, c'est ça, j'ai fait un peu de course au hasard. L'expression au hasard, Balthazar. Yossi, rien de spécial. Cherylyn, j'ai fait une promenade au bord du lac en attrapant des Pokémon. Eh oui, Cherylyn, elle attrape les Pokémon. Fiona qui nous dit, j'ai nettoyé la maison. Oui, moi aussi, j'ai tout rangé. Puis j'ai pris une douche et nous nous sommes bien reposés au lit. Vous, cela, j'ai cuisiné. Annabelle qui nous dit, je me suis promenée. Annabelle, you could start to put the thing in the passé composé. Let's be brave, Annabelle. You are a brave person. Hilary, je suis allée à l'église. Luciana, alors attendez, je suis allée à la messe et je regardais quelques vidéos pour le salut et l'esprit et la gratitude. Très bien. Yulia, j'ai... Alors, attendez. J'ai le week-end de 3M. Donc, ménager, faire le ménage, marcher et manger. C'est bien. Cosmina, comme d'habitude, le dimanche, j'ai fait les courses pour la semaine en cours. J'ai cuisiné. J'ai fait un gâteau sans sucre. Ça, c'est intéressant comme concept. Pourquoi ? J'ai regardé un film et j'ai lu les actualités, les nouvelles. Shahi, j'ai cuisiné un poulet tikka dans la maison ou à la maison et on a mangé ensemble. Sophia X, j'ai fait du ski alpin hier, mais la condition était terrible. La neige était molle et lourde à cause de la pluie et de la température plus haute. Oui, ça a changé les températures. Strange, d'accord. Oumila, j'ai regardé la série Friends. D'accord. Ah, c'est pas mal la série Friends, hein, ça change les idées. Denora, j'ai marché sur la plage. Sundar, j'ai fait de l'exercice comme d'habitude. Est-ce que vous voulez dire du sport ? Sonic, j'ai peint ma chambre parce que les murs étaient très sales. Très bien. Eh bien, ça, c'est formidable, la peinture. Get Real, j'aime ta voix, Vincent. Merci. Merci beaucoup, Get Real. Oh, c'est aimable. Alors, you should thank my parents. Hein. Il faut remercier mes parents. Ensuite, alors attendez, hier j'ai coupé mes cheveux. Yann Arte, je me suis détendu hier. Sandra qui nous dit salut, bonjour Sandra, participez. You can participate, write a sentence or wait for the next exercise. Rita, j'ai rendu visite à mon ami. Ice Cubes, coucou, j'ai joué un peu de violon après mon cours de japonais. Mais Ice Cubes, you were studying Chinese before it was not Japanese? You've been switching? J'ai vu 5 parties de la série Dérapage et j'ai gardé le petit pigeon. Dérapage? Quelle série est-ce que c'est? Est-ce que c'est Engrenage? Est-ce que c'est la série française? Fiona, n'oubliez pas de cliquer. Oui, c'est vrai. Et Ice Cube, le pigeon est prêt à voler. Waouh! Le pigeon est prêt à voler. Stardust nous rejoint. Bonjour! Naisu qui envoie un petit message. You're 78 persons right now, so basically, if you want to thank me or to be nice with me, you can click on the like. The objective is to try to reach 100 for this lesson. It should be possible. Alors, à vos téléphones, remember that it's possible. So normally I will do that only for the intermediate and the advanced lessons. So I've been receiving 2 things already from, it was, I guess, from Julia and then from Victoria Jacques. So it will be for tomorrow. But then if you want to participate, if you want to send a picture with a little text in French, well, you can do it. And I will include that in the lesson and we'll have an exercise or an activity with it. Merci. Allez, we'll start with the vocabulary exercise now and we'll discover 15 qualities. So we'll see how they work in French. So of course, as usually, we will have, well, in fact, the English version, and then you will give me the translation in French. How would you say brave? So we're talking about adjectives. How would you say brave in French? If you have different versions, so basically, give me the masculine and the feminine also. Alors, Ice Cubes, dérapage avec Eric Cantona. I'm not sure. I thought you were talking about Engrenage, which is this this police series, the French one, and I've been watching the whole thing because it was really good. Mm-hmm. Alors, oui, faites attention, so be careful, Hillary, because brave, it used to be like that a long time ago, but then it was replaced by courageux and courageuse. Now, brave has a more or less a negative connotation. So we don't really use brave now, but we will use courageux, so which is the masculine form, and then the feminine form will be courageuse. Courageux, courageuse, d'accord? So let's have a look at numéro 2. Numéro 2, how could you say calm in French? Alors, effectivement, so congratulations, it's quite good. In fact, we've got only one. Ah, d'accord, c'est intéressant. So, first translation, we agree it should be basically calm. And calm is one of these adjectives who has the same form, whether it's masculine or feminine. But then it's interesting because, well, Sonic is offering tranquille. Of course, it's a question of context. So tranquille could be an option. Remember that tranquille has the same form in the masculine or feminine form. Cosmina is offering silencieux, silencieuse, which would be yes, another good possibility, but also it depends on the context. So calm would be the first one, tranquille would be totally okay according to the context, and then silencieux, silencieuse, tout. Voilà. Pouvez-vous, Urmila, recommander une bonne série française? Well, I've been doing that already several times. Allez, numéro 3, numéro 3, cautious. Comment est-ce que vous pourriez traduire cautious? How could you translate that, well, in French? Alors, Cosmina, with the cake, without the sugar, I mean, she's got a lot of energy, hein? Fais attention. It will be interesting to see. But why no sugar? This is my question, Cosmina. Pourquoi pas de sucre dans le gâteau? Alors, prudent, prudente. Yeah, it's good. So we have, as you can see in that case, two different versions, obviously the masculine, which is the basic one, and then the feminine one. After that, Ice Cubes is giving a good possibility to vigilant, vigilante. Oui. It's not really used as much as prudent and prudente, Ice Cubes, but it could be good. Context could be somehow slightly different, but then prudent, prudente might be the best option in that case. Numéro 4, smiling. Could you give me the translation in French? Allez-y. Ah, mais là je comprends, Cosmina. D'accord. Mais est-ce que c'est... Ok, faudrait discuter. Qu'est-ce qu'on met pour remplacer la petite douceur? Alors, in that case, yeah, the best option, because to smile is sourire, hein? The verb is sourire. It's not really rire, because rire is really to laugh. So it's under laugh, in fact, sourire. So the adjective would be souriant, as Sherilyn has been offering, which was really good, and then the feminine form, souriante. So souriant would be the masculine, souriante would be the feminine form. I'm looking at your forms. Be careful. Cosmina, rire would be it's really to laugh. So it's the next stage, in fact. Hein? And really, sourire, it's like under laugh. Allez, souriant et souriante. Numéro 5, self-confident. How could you translate that into French? Alors, Ashwati is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. You can participate. So we're doing some qualities. And of course, I mean, we're translating from English to French. Sherilyn is the first one. And look, Sherilyn, we've got exactly the same thing as quite often. Cosmina is there too. It's good. Confiant, confiante. Oui. Oui, Julia, you could go for sûr if you want. Sûr de soi would be as Sherilyn is offering. Remember that sûr will be, well, the masculine, S-U, accent circonflexe, R, and then you add the E for the feminine form. So, thank you, Gloria, for the... I cannot do everything. I can't put all the things. Ashwati, je suis en retard. It's okay, don't worry. Confidante, be careful, Denora, because in French we don't really have confident. Confidence, it's confiant ou confiante. Luciana, confiante de soi-même. You don't really need to say confiante de soi-même. If you say confiant, in that case, or then confiante, obviously the feminine form, you don't need to put de soi-même. You will put it if you want to use sûr, hein, as you say, sûr de soi would be the other option. Très bien. Stevia, Cosmina. Oui. Yeah, I've been trying this stevia, but it was a few years ago already. Oui. Stevia, c'était pas mal. Numéro 6, regardez, intelligent. Alors, Sophia is asking, comment on dit self? Well, it depends, but it's soi-même, soi. It depends on the context. It's not as simple as in English, this self thing. So, let's have a look, because in that case, it's quite simple too. As you can see, I mean, the adjective is intelligent, masculine form, feminine form, the usual way. You just add a in the end, and you get intelligente. Hein? So, intelligent, masculine, intelligente, feminine. Remember that the first EN, it will be a nasal. So, for the pronunciation, it's really un, un, un. Intelligent, intelligente. Numéro 7, faithful. Alors, oui, ok, plusieurs possibilités, so we've got several options in that case. Well, the first one would be fidèle. Fidèle. Alors, Cosmina is offering loyal. Yeah. Well, it's not the straight direct translation, but then in most of the cases, it's possible to use loyal and loyal. So masculine and feminine. You will pronounce them exactly the same way. Yossi is offering the two. Remember that Yossi and, well, look at Cosmina. So she's been putting the feminine form because loyal, masculine, A-L, becomes A-L-E for the feminine, even if you pronounce them the same way. But, well, let's say that the first translation would be fidèle, d'accord? And then loyal is coming second. How could you say friendly in French? Allez-y. Alors, oui, faites attention. Oubila, faites attention. It's a common mistake to put amicable. It doesn't exist. In fact, you've got weather. Let's see. Amical, so the option that I've been offering you. I'm looking at the other thing. Cosmina is going for convivial. Convivial, well, depending on the context, same thing, but it's quite good. Well, if you're talking about a person, you might want to go for amical instead of convivial. But convivial could be for an event, for instance. I'm looking at the others. No, I mean, you're going for amical, amical. Yossi is going for gentil. Oui, same thing here. It depends on the context, and usually you're talking about a person. Remember, you'll see that gentil, I-L, will become gentille, I-L-L. For the feminine. So you can really hear the difference between gentil, masculine, gentille, feminine. So, Ice Cube's mieux amicable. Non! Non, 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 je ne veux pas de amicable. So, amical would be an option. Aimable could be an option because I think that somehow people tend to mix the two, aimable and amical, and they give me amicable. Non, it doesn't yet exist. Numéro 9. Numéro 9, this one should be quite simple, I hope. Generous, how could you say that into French? Alors, regardons. Généreux, généreuse. Oui. Yossi, sympathique. No, not really. Because in that case, you're talking about... It's slightly different, I mean, in that situation. It would be extremely difficult to negotiate on this one, Yossi. So I was expecting, yes, this généreux, généreuse. So once again, remember that the masculine form will be E-U-X, and then the feminine form will be E-U-S, généreux, masculin, généreuse, féminin, d'accord. Numéro 10, on continue, humble, I'm sorry, sorry, humble. Thank you. Alors oui, effectivement. Well, as you probably heard, I made this, well, simple, maybe stupid mistake. I read it the French way. So we do have humble also in French. So as you can see, it will be masculine and feminine, so it doesn't change. And well, the second option would be modeste, as Cosmina was offering. She was offering modeste. Good. The other one went for humble. So remember that pronunciation of U and M together, it's a nasal, like in parfum. Remember, we talked about that. U, M together, it's un. So it's like UN. And then, well, in that situation, you will pronounce it humble. Humble. Ice cubes, merci Vincent. It's Monday. Huh? It's Monday. Let's not expect too much. If the machines are working, I am doing my best. Allez, numéro 11. Allez, et c'est Julia. Julia is the first one, but then she was not generous enough because she didn't give the second N that we should have. So, un net in French is with two N. And then, well, it's in that case, like you saw, for the masculine and the feminine, it will be exactly the same thing. After that, Cosmina is offering juste. Oui. Same thing. It's a, I mean, according to the context, but still, it's extremely close. And then franche, yeah. Well, it could be like honest or then frank. Frank is the first translation, but we agree that all these things, I mean, are synonym. Sincère is offering Yossi. It's the same thing. Yes, in certain situations, I mean, it would be totally good. So honnête, juste, franc. Franche, sincère, I mean, all these things are extremely, extremely good. Cassandra is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. You can participate. We're seeing, we're discovering the qualities that we would hope to have. And so this one is optimistic. Alors, let's have a look at your things. Well, I'm offering, I mean, the first translation, direct translation, which would be, in fact, optimiste. Cosmina is offering another option, positive, positive. Oui, it could be extremely good too. In most of the cases, you are sticking to the direct translation. Alors, by the way, oui, Shirley, I always have this problem with the silent H in English. I'm sorry about that. Pardon! It's like hairdresser, no? Nicolas went to the hairdresser, he came back, he was so nice. He's got some, I mean, like short hair now. Oh, he was so nice when he came. Allez, numéro 13, number 13. Oh, this one should be really, really simple. Patient, allez-y. Mm-hmm. Riena Faire is joining us. Bonjour, you can join. I mean, we're doing some translation. Alors, bébé Moët, every French person I know does the H thing. You mean being too generous with the H? Ah, because we need to, we're so stressed about trying to pronounce it all the time. Alors, in that case, it's patient. Well, basically, it's exactly the same thing as you can see, but then because it ends with T, it will be with the feminine form, with the extra E, I mean the usual one. So patient will be the masculine, and then patiente will be the feminine form. Rupa is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour, Rupa, you can participate. Allez, numéro 14. Probably it should have been number 1, polite. Chérie, yeah, no worries, all the French people also don't pronounce the H. But yeah, because we're so stressed about trying to pronounce it at all costs, that after that, when somebody tells us you don't pronounce it, we're just like, no, no, no. Alors, regardons, oui, effectivement, hein, so in that case, as you can see, poli is written like that. In fact, the masculine form is extremely short, P-O-L-I, and the feminine form will be pronounced exactly the same way, but then you add the E in the end. Cosmina, oui, courtois, courtoise, it's totally correct. Grace is going for courtoise too. Okay, remember, Grace, that the masculine form would be courtois, d'accord, and the feminine form will be courtoise. We don't use it as much as we used to before. D'accord. Poli started to replace this courtois and courtoise big time. Vous slat poli, gentil, gentil. Oui, depends on the context. I mean, this gentil, gentil, gentil is really nice or kind. So, of course, it means that the person, I mean, is polite at the same time. If you really want to speak about the politeness and narrow it, in that case, poli would be better, and then courtois would be also extremely good. Très bien, allez, on continue. Alors, Fiona, désolé de déranger la classe. Nicolas est votre femme. Non, Nicolas est mon fils. C'est mon fils. C'est mon fils qui a 11 ans. Et Yasmine, c'est ma fille qui a 21 ans. Ah non, non, Nicolas, c'est mon fils. C'est un petit garçon délicieux et magnifique. Alors, regardons, oui, in that situation, it's difficult to really find something else. Well, Julia is going for franc, franche. Yeah, be careful, don't put demand, because in that situation, it would be the adverb. Sincère would be the first option, but then you're right, Julia, it could be franc and franche in certain situations. Gloria is talking about... People like my orchidée, hein. Elle est magnifique. Alors, sincère would be the first option and then franche because I don't see any other options that you're offering. Merci beaucoup. And it's true that you are more than 100, so maybe you should click. It would be nice. Thank you very much. Remember that the idea is to try to reach, to touch the 100 together. Alors, Ice Cube qui dit presque tous les adjectifs sont similaires à l'anglais, l'ingles. Qu'est-ce que c'est? Est-ce que... Eh oui. Allez, find one word, as you remember. It's extremely, extremely simple. Alors, attendez, Cassandra, parfois Nicolas vient appeler. Oui. Mais là, and that's the reason why I didn't start the lesson on time, because I was waiting for Nicolas to come back from the hairdresser. So now he's ready with a short hair and he's got some food, so it should be okay. We'll see. Allez, let's try to find one word, and only one, please, because if you put several words, it could last a bit too long. So one word that will start with U, hein, la lettre U, s'il vous plaît. Alors, Edgley Costa says, it is difficult, sorry, it's easy for me to understand almost all that what you say, but it's difficult for me to start structuring sentences. It's totally normal, Edgley, don't worry. You're not the first one. Go for it. Try, and you will make it. No stress. Ashwati, un uniforme. You put E in the end and it will be perfect. Denora, utilisé. Yesero, unique. Luciana, unique. Omar, uniquement, adverbe. Cosmina, uniformisé. Oui, ça c'est pas un beau verbe. Ah, ça dépend du contexte. Tenzin, utilisé. Sophia X, universitaire. Universitaire, so the adjective it will be once again the same for the masculine and the feminine. Lynn, utilisé. Be careful, Lynn, because utilisé is not with Z, but with S. D'accord. Ice Cubes, urgent. Très bien. Féminin would be urgente. Julia, unicorne. Mm-mm. In French, it's more. We don't use really unicorn, but we use licorne. Hein? If you're talking about the animal that doesn't really exist. Hein? ensuite, Cassandra. Ultimate, non, ultime would be better. Sandra, utilisé. Victoria, take your time. Oui, it's true. Edgley, go easy. Hein. Don't stress. Try your best and you will see that little by little it will come. Yossi, utilisé. Une, no accent. Cheryline, upiki. Mais qu'est-ce que c'est comme mot? Ubiquitination. Qu'est-ce que vous trouvez comme mot, chère Eline? Vous voulez me tester. Raphaël, une. Yann Arte, union. Ensuite, qu'est-ce qu'il y a? Annabelle qui nous dit uni. Très bien. So remember that uni, it's the same. I mean this adjective. If it's the masculine like you put here, it will be e. If it's the feminine form, you will add this e, but then you won't pronounce it. Vous, slat, urgent, urgente. Shahi, l'usine. Julia, and we try. La fameuse chanson. Gloria, Hubert. Non. Oh, it's so nice. There is a story because at the beginning of this Uber thing, my mother, she didn't know that it was a brand. So she thought it was the name Uber that does exist. And she had a brother that was called Uber. So she was pronouncing it the French way. Uber. Olga, urgent. Ouais. Alors attendez, Victoria Ultime, Hillary Utopique, Habibi, bonjour, bonjour, et Fiona Urgence, Felipe Unique. Allez, on continue. R, s'il vous plaît, un mot avec R. Don't forget to put, so let's try to take the time, if you want to put a substantive or a noun, put the article. If you want to put an adjective, let's try to put the two forms. D'accord? So maybe not one word, but then if there is a feminine form, well, put it too. Merci. Alors, ça commence. Cosmina Ratiociné. Strange qui nous dit une rue. Ashwati, une randonnée. Denora, rarement. Yann Arte, rien. Fiona Adams, rien. Lynn, la randonnée. Be careful, it's feminine. Look right above you, Lynn, because Ashwati has been writing it properly. So you can see that in the end, it's E, accent aigu E. D'accord? Sophia X, la résistance. Raphaël, rire, d'accord. Rire, it's interesting, Raphaël, because it's, can, I mean, of course, it's the verb, but it can be also a noun, le rire. Luciana, la raison. Tenzin, rire. Yesero, rouge. Shahi, remplir. Stardust, repose, d'accord. Alors, reposer, it's interesting, because it can be whether to put something again, remember, hein, poser, it's to put something on the table, for instance, reposer, it's to put again. If you start to put the reflexive form, in that case, se reposer, it's to rest, so it's totally different, hein, so really be careful with reposer, to put again, and se reposer. In some cases, this se can really change the meaning. Riena, ridicule. Yossi, retrouver. Sandra, radeau. Akash, how much it will take to be fluent? It's the question that I've been hearing so many times, and there is no answer for that. I don't know you, Akash. I've been seeing all the scenarios possible regarding the time or the amount of time needed to become fluent in French. I don't know, because I need to know exactly what are your skills, and in most of the cases, Akash, you know it. If you can learn a language, if you can learn something else, quite fast, it means that you will probably learn French quite fast too. It's extremely personal as a question. Olga Rambard, de féminin. Raphaël, remplacé. Luciana. Interesting. And really, main concept, la résilience. I mean, we could make several lessons on that, because la résilience is an interesting concept that we'd like to discuss about. Fermin, regardez. Julia, rébarbatif. Oh là là, beaucoup, beaucoup de choses. Omar. Merci beaucoup, Omar. La ratatouille. Allez, on y va. Please write me one word with the letter I. On y va. Alors, and I excuse, she's reading, if you're a Latin native, it's very fast. Well, of course, she wants to brag. She wants to brag because she's Italian. Eh ben, bravo, Ice Cubes. After that, people will be stressed. Alors, ça commence, Fiona qui nous dit « Intéressant, très bien, feminine form would be intéressé. M&M, une idée. » Ok, « You've been extremely generous, M&M 19. You've been putting 3 R in a row. Hein? Only two, if that's okay with you. The last one, maybe not. » Kai Kai qui dit « Intéressé. » Raphaël, « Impossible. » Sophia X, « Isolé. » Cosmina, « Incoactive. » Qu'est-ce que c'est? Je ne sais même pas ce que c'est. Ut, emporté. Tenzin, inspire, inspiré, would be the verb. Luciana, imaginer. Marco, immersion. Athéna, inspiré. Yanarte, important, importante, effectivement. Ice Cube, she's laughing, of course, because pff, it's too easy for you. Mouskan, intensité. Victoria, Jacques, improbable. I really love this adjective. Improbable, c'est formidable, je trouve. Rupa, imparfait. Anne qui nous dit interdire. Denora, impression. Riena, inconcevable. Très bien. Vous, cela, une imitation. Parfait. Hilary, intéressant, intéressante. Très bien. Yossi, informatique. Olga Ruiz, insolite. Passant qui nous dit bonsoir. Bonsoir, intelligent. And the feminine form would be intelligente. Omar, inconnu. Annabelle, intense. Julia qui dit idéal. Est-ce que c'est possible? On ne sait pas. Yesero, une île, féminin. Shari, infirmière, féminin, masculin, infirmier. Cassandra, indispensable. Ferman, intensif. Ya, Zou, incroyable. Habibi, il. Hey, Habibi. Next time, try to give me a longer one. Merci beaucoup. It is not serious at all. Not serious at all, because basically you're 103 persons. At one point we were reaching 105, but then I've got only 88 likes. Please click on the like, it would be really nice. Alors, the video of the day. Let's see if it works, and it should work. I just need to go there and click. Allez, une phrase pour décrire ou commenter cette vidéo. Give me one sentence to describe or to comment the video. Merci. So as you can notice, I'm putting some cats now. I put some cats just to attract the clicks. If you like the cat, not talking about me, in fact, don't think about me. Click for the cat. Alors, Marco qui nous dit « Je veux mon doudou pour aller dormir. » Ok, Yann qui dit « Je me souviens de mon chat. » Ice Cubes qui dit « Je veux un chat mignon comme ça. » Bah oui, c'est tellement mignon, c'est tout petit. Denora, veux-tu avoir une manucure? Oui, c'est dangereux, hein? It's dangerous because after that it's scratch. Olga qui nous dit elle caresse le petit chat ou le chaton. Très bien, Olga. Riena, le chat est heureux d'être caressé. Très bien. Anne qui nous dit j'adore. Très adorable. Rupa, le beau chat est joyeux ou soyeux. D'accord. Kai Kai, le chat est beau. Victoria Jacques, un chat adorable qui a probablement griffé la personne après. I agree, Victoria Jacques. You can't trust a cat. It's not possible. A dog, it's another story. The cat, you can't trust a cat. Luciana, nous devrions apprendre beaucoup avec des animaux, c'est vrai. Edgley, but Edgley, try to make some short sentences. Bumblebee, le chat, est petit, d'accord? Remember that petit should be definitely in the masculine form, P-E-T-I. Alors attendez, Julia, oh incroyable, je viens de regarder la vidéo comme ça avant la leçon. Hein? Ah, you cannot do that with a dog? Of course you can. Of course you can do everything with a dog. Mercurial, le chat dit, pourquoi vous me laissez pas seul? Sandra qui dit, quel joli chat! Eh oui, Ut, ce chat est si doux. M&M19, les chats sont adorables et je suis a cat lady. Ah, les chiens, c'est bien aussi. M&M19, les chiens, c'est pas mal. It's not bad, hein. Vous, Slat, c'est une vidéo d'un chat qui est très mignon. Oui. Hilary, le chat se sent aimé et il est content, c'est vrai. Cherylyn, le chat attend le moment idéal pour manger la main de la personne. Maybe just a finger. Manger, cring, un petit bout de doigt. Yossi, le chat est caressé par son propriétaire. Cassandra, le chat pense, arrête de jouer avec moi, je veux de la nourriture, s'il te plaît. Tenzin, le chiot, c'est pas un chiot, c'est un chaton, est embrassé, plutôt caressé, par son patron propriétaire. Cosmina, je ne peux pas même regarder cette vidéo avec cette bête, ce fauve dangereux qui est prêt à mutiler sa proie. Après, il va se jeter sur l'autre. Yesero, le chat veut qu'on son serviteur lui donne un massage. Fizzle, le chat a des cheveux longs. Alors, ce n'est pas des cheveux, c'est des poils. Ashwati, le chat aime quand quelqu'un le chouchoute très très bien. Je regarde Stardust. Mon chat Paul. Le chaton ressemble à mon chat. Il s'assied à côté de moi. Quand j'apprends le français, il me parle et parfois, il me rend fou. Ah ben ça, les chats, il faut faire attention. Hugo nous rejoint. Bonjour, Hugo. Annabelle qui dit, ses yeux te regardent magnifiquement. Ah ben, il est mignon. Il est très, très mignon. One more click on the like and then we reach the 100 and after that I will be so happy. So please, if you didn't click yet on the like, well, it would be nice to do it right now. Allez, the numbers of the day. And I'm not sure if... Ooh! So we did it. We did it. We reached the 100. So now we can concentrate on the lesson. So remember, the numbers of the day, it's a simple exercise. I mean, the concept is simple. We'll have some numbers. We'll start with the number one. Number one, one digit. Number two, two digits, etc. On y va. Let's start with the first one. So I will read it twice. Deux. Go for it. Alors, Olga is saying it's because of the cat. I think it is. Olga, now I will just put some cats or dogs to grab more likes. I guess it will be the only way. Alors, let's look at the things that you're writing. Yeah, it's really good in that case. It was not really difficult. So you wrote it the way you want, whether the numbers or with the letters. So it was deux. It's quite clear in that situation. So let's have a look at the number two. Number two will have, two digits. So I will read it twice too. 46. 46. 6. Alors oui, très bien, hein, félicitations, so far so good, 46, hein, 4 et 6, 4 and 6, so 46, 46. Let's have a look at numéro 3, well, we'll have 3 digits, so same thing here, I will read it twice. 187, allez-y. Alors, I am looking at your things. Be careful, Victoria Jacques. You were not generous enough. I mean, you were extremely close. You've been writing 186, but I said 187. Be careful, Denora. You wrote 147, which is quite close, but then it was 187. I'm looking at the others. Apparently. Stella, bonjour, je suis ici pour la dictée. Oh, it's coming, but I don't know when, because I've been preparing that during the day, so, but then, let's see. Numéro 4, musique mystérieuse, et oui. Une musique numéro 4 will have 4 digits. I will, as usual, read it twice. 9703. 9703. Allez-y. Alors, oui, très bien, hein, so far so good, 9703, so let's agree on the fact that 1000 is 1000, 9000 is 9000. After that, 100, 100, 700, 700. So I start to combine the two things, 9700, 9700, and then in the end, I just need to add the 3, 9703. And the last one for this exercise will be with 5 digits, so same thing here, I will read it twice. 75831. 75831. Allez-y. Alors, this was the last one, so 75, 1000, so 75,000. After that, 800, 800, 31, 31. 75,831. D'accord? Yansu, is it too much? Stop! Yansu, no problem, it was the last one. And we'll do something different now. Allez, the classic question. What is she thinking about? À quoi pense-t-elle? Write me one sentence, please. Alors, c'est Shai qui commence. Shai is the first one. Elle pense à écrire ou à quoi écrire dans l'examen. Be careful, l'examen, you don't write it like that. Sophia X, elle pense que cet examen est vraiment difficile. Denora, oui, je suis coupable. Cosmina, elle est dans un état d'hypnose avec le... Stella, elle a l'air de penser à quelque chose de sérieux. Peut-être qu'elle essaye de résoudre un problème, peut-être, ou une sorte d'équation terrible. Vuslat, elle pense à ses devoirs. Mercurialman, elle pourrait penser à n'importe quoi. Très bien. Lynn, elle pense comme moi. Comment est-ce que j'écris en français? Bumblebee, elle pense à l'argent. Vous pensez Stardust, elle pense. Pourquoi dois-je attendre des heures chez le médecin, même si j'ai un rendez-vous? On sent l'expérience personnelle qui parle. Olga qui nous dit, elle pense à caresser, qu'elle veut caresser un chat. Ashwati, elle pense à son copain, il lui manque beaucoup. Fiona, elle pense à quoi préparer pour le dîner. Elle a qu'à laisser, elle a qu'à laisser son copain préparer. Allez hop, M&M19, c'est le premier du mois, je dois payer mes factures. c'est vrai, MNM19, on doit payer les factures. Cassandra, elle pense qu'elle devrait quitter son emploi. Bébé Moët, elle est triste parce qu'elle n'habite pas en France. Ferman, trop cher ses chaussures. Propos 5, elle pense à ses devoirs. Hillary, elle pense qu'elle va à ce qu'elle va manger ce soir. Omar, elle pense quoi faire demain pour le petit déjeuner ou peut-être le déjeuner. Luciana qui nous dit pourquoi le groupe de Vincent que Vincent aime s'est brisé. Ah, oh oui, Daft Punk. Pourquoi? Mais que se passe-t-il? J'ai vu un documentaire, I saw this documentary on them, it was so good, really good. Francis, elle pense au problème qu'elle a. Rupa, elle pense avec beaucoup de problèmes avec sa fille. Ou est-ce qu'elle a beaucoup de problèmes avec sa fille? Julia qui dit, encore des oignons, comment je les coupe sans larmes? We've been covering this topic. Now we know exactly how to cut the onions, thanks to you, without crying. Yann Arte, elle pense qu'il y a des examens dans le domaine. Yossi, elle vérifie les factures. Marco, elle est dans les toilettes. Oh, mais qu'est-ce que c'est, Marco, voyons. Voyons, Marco, Marco, ça n'est pas raisonnable. Kai Kai, elle pense à ses études. Gloria, que dois-je coudre? Ice Cubes, elle pense que le français n'est pas très difficile comme le japonais. Probablement. Annabelle, la manicure a peint mes ongles trop brillants. Cling, cling, cling. Fizzle, elle a reçu un message de son travail et elle ne veut pas y aller. C'est pas la peine d'y aller, c'est vrai. Hein. So if you just joined and you didn't have the time to click, don't forget to click on the like, it would be really great. Ah, Victoria Jacques, elle pense pourquoi les chelmes ment-elles? I think you're talking about la balance. Hein? The one... Quand vous regardez pour les kilos, c'est ça le problème. La balance ment toujours. Allez, let's continue. How would you translate? And it's the first one. Well, simple sentences, translate them. I want to be happy. Alors, effectivement, so in that case, it's quite simple. I've been putting, sorry, I didn't put it strange. Normally, I put all the forms. So, give me one second. Whether it will be, well, the masculine form, or then the feminine form. Feminine form would be heureuse. So, I'm looking at the things. Tenzin is going for content. Heureux would be probably the best way, d'accord? So, heureux, as we had previously, heureuse, E-U-S-E, would be possible. So, je veux être heureux ou je veux être heureuse. Numéro 2, I like to help others. How could you translate that into French? Alors, Yossi has to leave. Au revoir, Yossi. À bientôt. Alors, oui. So, well, the first option that I was offering here is j'aime aider les autres. So, most of you have been using this thing. Kai Kai is going for j'aime. Well, don't put pour. In that case, you just stick with the aider. Les gens could be possible. Don't forget to put aider in the infinitive because it's a second verb that is coming right after aimer, that is already conjugated. So, j'aime aider the others, or others will be les autres, would be the best option in that case. And I think that most of you went there. Bébé Moët, j'aime aider les autres. Oui, pas de problème. Numéro 3, I don't want to be manipulated. Eh oui! Allez, how could you translate that? Alors, je regarde, oui, effectivement. So here, it's the same, and we don't really have a lot of options. So the first one would be to use, well, obviously, the verb vouloir in the present form, negative form, je ne veux pas. And after that, this is the tricky thing. Remember that in that case, we have to put the verb manipuler, but we have to transform it in the passive form, être manipulé. And because we write it like that, and when it comes to the passive form, we write it with être, it means that manipulé, in fact, will be in the feminine form if the person is feminine. Je ne veux pas être manipulé, masculine form, accent aigu, feminine form, accent aigu, D'accord. You pronounce them exactly the same way. Luis Antonio, I think you're not really synchronized with us. Try to refresh your stream. Numéro 4, I want to be respected. I want to be respected. How could you write that in French? Alors, Luciana is asking, liaison, pas être ou pas être. Oui, c'est optionnel. It's up to you, in fact, in that that situation. So I'm looking at the thing. Let's look at the options here. It's actually quite simple here too. Well, remember that we have to use the verb, vouloir, one more time, in the present. So, je veux, and then the structure that will continue is être respecté. Same thing here, and it's this passive form of respecter. So it means that you will have to put in the end of your respecter the feminine if needed. Je veux être respecté, which is in fact the masculine form, e accent aigu, je veux être respecté, e accent aigu, e. For the feminine form, you will pronounce them exactly the same way. Numéro 5, s'il vous plaît. I have the right not to accept everything. Allez-y. Alors, I am looking at your things. Let's agree that Sherilyn, has the proper version, because normally to should be before accepté, but we agree that Cosmina is putting to after, and it's quite flexible, in fact. Normally it should be before the verb, but if you put accepté to, it's totally possible. It's a bit less formal, but it's totally possible. So, j'ai le droit de ne pas tout accepter. This is the proper way, but then it's true that you could hear j'ai le droit de ne pas accepter tout, which is less formal, because normally tout should be definitely before the infinitive. J'ai le droit de ne pas tout accepter. J'ai le droit de ne pas accepter tout. Be careful, Tenzin. Tout should be definitely T-O-U-T. Same thing for Vouslat, T-O-U-T. M&M goes for tout ça, no problem. I mean, if you want to put tout ça, it's interesting. In fact, it's nice. It's nice to be careful, Omar. It's not really quelque chose. In that case, it's really tout. Merci beaucoup. So if you didn't have the time to click on the like yet, it's the time now to do it. Thank you very much. Alors, when I see that, and especially this picture, when I see that, continue the sentence. Continue the sentence, I've got no clue, build me a sentence with... Quand je vois... Ah ben non, c'est bizarre. Quand je vois ça... I will write it. Quand je vois ça. So try to tell me what do you think about when you see that. Quand je vois... Hop là, I will put cela. Tiens, let's be nice. Allez, write me a sentence. Alors, Bébé Boët nous dit, quand je vois cela, ou quand je vois ça, j'ai faim. Louise, quand je vois ça, je veux aider les autres. Ah non, Louise, you need to refresh. Gloria, je sais que tu fais du pain. C'est possible, Rupa, j'ai très faim. Lynn, je veux manger. Olga, quand je vois ça, j'ai besoin de manger. Stella qui nous dit, quand je vois ça, je veux manger quelque chose de délicieux. Sophia X, quand je vois ça, j'ai faim. Ah oui, tout le monde a faim maintenant. Luciana, quand je vois ça, je pense à la nourriture. Hilary qui dit, quand je vois ça, je dois nettoyer. Ah oui, surtout si vous soufflez. Après, c'est une horreur. Mercurialman, quand je vois ça, je pense que trop de sel a été utilisé sur le repas. Ah, est-ce que c'est du sel ou de la farine? Moi, je croyais que c'était de la farine. Français qui dit, je commence à avoir faim. MNM19, quand je vois ça, je pense à manger des choses sucrées. By CD, j'imagine que tu veux manger. Ice Cubes, quand je vois ça, c'est l'heure de manger. Et on sait que maintenant, Ice Cubes, elle a envie d'ouvrir le frigo. C'est l'heure du frigo. Luciana, d'accord. Shahi, quand je vois une cuillère et une fourchette, j'ai faim. Fiona Adams, quand je vois ça, ça me rappelle la nourriture et maintenant, j'ai faim. Kai Kai qui dit, je veux beaucoup manger. Tout le monde parle de nourriture, c'est normal. Fizzle, je sais que le chef a fait un gâchis dans la cuisine. Cheryline qui dit, quelqu'un doit avoir assassiné la cuillère et la fourchette. Oui, c'est ça, c'est qu'il y a des traces. Sherlock Holmes va arriver. Marco, quand je vois cela, c'est l'heure d'aller manger. Eh ouais. Propos, quand je vois ça, j'ai faim. Tenzin, je suis à mon travail. Ah, vous travaillez dans une cuisine, Tenzin. Ou dans un restaurant. Victoria, quand je vois cela, il est temps d'aller manger. Ben écoutez, je regarde Julia, quand je vois ça, je veux lécher tout ce sucre en poudre. Mais est-ce que c'est du sucre en poudre ou est-ce que c'est de la farine? Ça n'est pas clair. Alors, we've been starting with the qualities and now we're covering the flaws. So the negative aspect, because we need to be objective at one point. Numéro 1, how could you translate clumsy into French? Thank you. Alors, c'est Fiona. Fiona is the first one. Félicitations. Don't forget to put, if it's possible, the masculine and the feminine. And the idea is to try to see, because we're talking about adjectives in that case. So, if it's the same form or if we have two forms for these adjectives. And in that case, we definitely have two forms. So, maladroit would be the best option for the translation as you've been offering so far. It's good. And then, well, the feminine form, you will add this in the end and you will pronounce it slightly differently because maladroit, masculine, final T not pronounced. And then feminine form, maladroite, t, you will pronounce it. D'accord? So maladroit, masculine, maladroite, feminine form. Number two, numéro deux, bossy. How could you translate this bossy adjective? Alors, Julien, maladroit, c'est bien à gauche, eh oui. It's possible to use also this gauche as an adjective. Alors, in that situation, autoritaire would be the best option, I guess, as far as I can see. Yeah, so autoritaire, tyrannique, it's... Cosmina is going for tyrannique. It's, well, yeah, I mean, you reach some you cross some boundaries in that case, but then yeah, it's a bit the same. It's a bit stronger. Let's agree on that. Huh? So autoritaire would be good. Directif is not bad. Hilary, bon, tyrannique, it's a bit too much. Gloria wants to go for the tyrannique too. D'accord. Comme un patron, nous dit propos 5. Numéro 3, number 3, careless. How could you translate careless? Chérie Lune, comme ma directrice de thèse! Alors, Cheryline est la première, félicitations. Négligente would be probably the best option. Cosmina is going for the same. Marco, too. Bravo. Remember, Marco, if you've got the accent on your keyboard, I don't know if you have them. Definitely, we should have an accent aigu on the first E. So it's good. Remember, Julia, we have the masculine and the feminine form. So it would be good to try to put them. So négligent, négligente. Imprudent, well, it depends, Hilary, it depends on the context. It would not be the first option, but in some cases, this imprudent concept could be, yes, translated with this careless, but be careful, it's not the first one that should come. So négligent and then imprudent would be another option. Julia qui dit incroyable, I do not know any of these words. This is the concept, Julia. It's a lesson, so the idea is to discover some new words, if possible, and it seems to be the case. Stardust has to go. Au revoir, Stardust, à bientôt. Numéro 4. Well, this one is interesting. How can you translate that into French? Alors, eh oui, regardez, hypocrite. Well, it's almost the same, in fact. Hypocrite has, well, has all these adjectives that will end with the same form, whether for masculin and feminin. Cosmina, côteleux, côteleuse. Well, the things, well, yeah, but don't go for the things that are a bit too old. Nobody will use it. I want to be honest with you. Nobody will use it. They will go for hypocrite. Yeah, so far so good. Hypocrite, Gloria, hypocrisie. Well, it's a substantive and it's feminine. L'hypocrisie. But then when you talk about the adjective, and in that case you want to go for the adjective, it's hypocrite, which, as I said, will have one form for the two gender, masculine and feminine. So let's have a look at numéro 5. Numéro 5, lazy. Alors, regardons ensemble. Let's have a look. Yep. So, first option would be paresseux, paresseuse. Fiona is going for feignant. So, feignant, but then we pronounce it feignant. And feminine form would be feignante, remember. So, masculine, you don't pronounce the T. And then feminine form, you will pronounce it. So, paresseux, paresseuse. And then feignant, feignante. And then Julia is like, I know this one. Annabelle, oui. Très bien, je regarde les autres, pas de problème. Let's have a look for number 6. Numéro 6, noisy. How could you translate that into French? Alors, Marco qui dit beaucoup de mots que je ne connais pas pour un Brésilien qui habite au Québec. C'est pas grave, vous pouvez les apprendre, c'est ça qui est bien. Regardons ensemble. So, let's have a look together. This one, yep, this one is actually, there are not a lot of options. In fact, I'm looking at your forms. No, so it's bruyant and bruyante. Remember, so same thing here, masculine form will end with A-N-T, and then the feminine form A-N-T-E, d'accord, you will pronounce this T in the end for the feminine. So, bruyant, and then bruyante. Numéro 7, allez, numéro 7, silly. How can you translate that into French? Alors, let's have a look. Charlotte is the first one. Charlotte is offering bête, oui, tout à fait. Bête, it's interesting because bête is, in fact, it's a substantive, it's a noun, une bête, but we can use it also as an adjective, bête. Same thing here, it will have the only one form for the masculine and the feminine. The other option would be, stupide. Same thing here. Alors, one second. Yann Arte is offering idiot. Why not? In fact, it's quite good. Idiot, remember that it should be idiot for the feminine. Julia is offering dinde. Yeah, well, We don't really use it anymore, but it could be possible depending on the context. So idiot, bête, or then stupid would be tout à fait. I mean, they would be really good. I'm looking at the things that you've been writing. Where that's it. Don't be careful because it's. No, not really, Julia. Let's agree that we should forget this one. Allez, let's go for selfish now. Cheryline, is there an alternative that doesn't read as stupid? Meaning what? If you go for this adjective, for this this meaning, it's quite strong. It is not nice at all. So it's extremely difficult to make any kind of. I mean, this is your question. You want to know which one is less stronger than the others. Try to define the question. Alors, in that case, yeah, I mean, egoist is probably the only, but I'm not really sure if you've got something else. Egoist will be the adjective that we will use. Same thing here, it will stand for the masculine and the feminine. Don't forget the tréma on the I, because this is the reason why you will pronounce it egoist, but not égoïste, hein. This is the use of this tréma. Allez, numéro 9, moody. Comment est-ce que vous pouvez traduire? How could you translate that into French? Ah, Julia, dingue! Dingue, oui, because dinde is turkey, and so. but dingue, it's like it's crazy. It's totally crazy. C'est dingue. Alors, oui, Fiona, she's got the first one, and then Cosmina, right after, has the second one. Marco, bipolaire. Let's agree that this bipolaire concept is when it is officially diagnosed by a doctor, Marco. So, we're talking about the first step when it's not clearly diagnosed. So, first option, which is quite interesting because in French we use this lunatique. Lunatique, connected to the moon. Hein? Connected to the moon, la lune. So, basically, your mood can change according to the moon. Voilà, lunatique. Hein? So, it doesn't mean the same thing as it does in English. And the other option is d'humeur changeante. Hein? Lunatique, or then d'humeur changeante. And then after that, as Marco has been offering, when a doctor starts to diagnose the thing, it can be, I mean, they've got other names for that. Allez, numéro 10, I'm waiting for you. Alors, Fiona was offering mal luné for the previous one. Not really, because mal luné, it's when you are not in a good mood, in a bad mood. So that's the reason why. And it's extremely interesting, Fiona, because by using this expression, I mean, clearly you can see that it's totally connected to la lune, the moon. Hein? So mal luné, bien luné would be the other option if you're in a good mood. So this is, it's slightly different, d'accord? Alors let's have a look now at this one. So we've got maybe several options if you want to offer me something. Well, I went for méprisant, méprisante. Omar is going for dédaigneux, which is quite good, in fact. Yes, remember, Omar, hein, that's your dédaigneux would be dédaigneuse in the feminine form. So, méprisant, méprisante, and then dédaigneux, dédaigneuse. And now Julia is discovering some new words in all the languages, which is extremely, extremely good. Ali, let's go for this one. Shallow. You have any idea how we could say that in French? Alors, effectivement, Mirsad, c'est le contraire de profond. Yeah, why not? Alors, Cosmina is going for the first the masculine, then the feminine, and then. So, yeah, superficiel would be probably the best option. Julia, in profond, un profond. Alors, Cherylyn, yes, I'm wondering which has the less strong connotation out of bête and stupid. In English, silly is not necessarily stupid. No, I know, but it has a negative connotation anyway. So I wonder if there is a word that can express the same nuance. We had somebody was offering so and sot, but still, it's not really nice. If you go for stupid, of course, you put the bar quite high. But bête is not. It's a bit less intense, but still it's extremely, it's not really nice. So the other option, Cherylyn, that normally we can use is to go for the opposite and we put the negative form. You see my point? So instead of saying that il est stupide, you can say il n'est pas très intelligent. So you put the negative with this very, is not very intelligent. So it does express exactly the same thing, but strangely somehow, it's not as strong because you're not using the adjective that, you know, is quite hurtful if you think about that. Il n'est pas très intelligent. It's another way to say il est stupide. Voilà. I don't know if I answered your question. Allez, let's have the next one. This one should be extremely simple, at least I hope. Moussa, comment on dit shallow-minded du coup? On dit superficiel, Moussa. Sorry, Moussa. Alors, effectivement, so the first option would be to go from, to go directly to the same thing. So, impatient, impatiente. Cosmina, of course, you want to go to pressé. Pressé could be, yeah, could be another option. Well, let's say that it's yeah, I mean, it's the same concept. You're not looking at the same thing from the same angle, but the result is the same. So, impatient is the first option, and then pressé could be totally acceptable. Pressé, remember, you will have to put this extra E in the end that you won't pronounce. Alors, Mirzad, pas patient. Yeah, I mean, you of course, you can use that when you talk, as I explained to Cherylyn. It's always possible to go for the negative form of the opposite. Il n'est pas patient, meaning by that, il est impatient. Elle n'est pas patiente, elle est impatiente. Of course. Numéro 13. How could you translate this one? Thank you. Alors, Finn Rider is sharing some interesting news. He or she is telling us, j'ai faim, j'ai faim. Well, it's possible to eat at the same time. I won't judge you. I won't judge you because I cannot see exactly what you're doing at the same time. Alors, same thing here, hein? It was just also to show you that we've got quite many adjectives that are extremely close to the English version. So in that case, you've got intolérant, masculine form, and then intolérante, feminine form. Allez, two more to go, and after that, it will be done with this one. This one should be also extremely, extremely simple. Alors, oui, don't forget to put the masculine form also, because there is a difference between the masculine form and the feminine form, as you can see, naïf, so masculine form ending with F, and then the feminine form, naïve, it will end with VE. Remember, this is the same thing as sportif, IF, sportive, IVE. That's usually the way it goes. In both of the cases, don't forget to put the tréma on the E, because one more time, this is the reason why, by putting this tréma on the E, it prevents you from making this connection between the A and the E. Normally, when you have A and E together, you get the sound E. But if you put the tréma, then it means that you will have to pronounce first A, na, and then separately you will pronounce the I, naïf, naïve. Hein? This is the way it will go. Allez, the last one, numéro 15, stubborn. How could you say stubborn in French? Mutsa is asking, the first one is always, when I put that, the first one is always the masculine, so naïf will be masculine, like sportif, masculine, naïve, feminine, sportive, feminine. This is my answer, Mutsa. Alors, Cosmina, oui, félicitations, Cheryline, same thing after with the accent, because you've got the accent on your keyboard, apparently. So, têtu and têtu, so masculine and feminine form. I'm looking if you have other option. Julia is offering obstiné, which is quite good. With the accent, it would be perfect. So, obstiné would be possible. Stella is giving the feminine form of obstiné. So, we have têtu, obstiné, Sophia, la tête dur. It's not an adjective. Unfortunately, Sophia, it's not really an adjective. So I accept obstiné. I accept têtu. What else? You've got, this is the only thing that you have. Julia, têtu, téton. Ah no, it's not the same at all. Têtu, and then feminine. Têtu with the E, but then you don't pronounce it. Rupa is offering obstiné too. Well, it's good. So let's agree on têtu and obstiné, masculine and feminine form. Olga Ruiz is giving entêté, which was the other option that I was waiting for. So têtu, entêté, obstiné would be extremely good. Merci beaucoup. Allez, let's continue. It's the best place. It's the best place. C'est le meilleur endroit pour continuer la phrase, s'il vous plaît. Alors, on y va. Let's have a look now. Mutsa say, I think, c'est le meilleur endroit pour réviser. Julia, c'est le meilleur endroit pour faire des choses. Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Ice Cube, c'est le meilleur endroit pour être contre la gravité. Cosmina, c'est le meilleur endroit pour rencontrer l'homme de ma vie. Et il en faut juste un, hein. C'est pas la peine d'en avoir 3 millions, un ça suffit, et là j'en vois un, c'est probable, il vous attend Cosmina, avec son drapeau. Marco, c'est le meilleur endroit pour réfléchir et regarder la Terre. Vuslad, c'est le meilleur endroit pour rencontrer des aliens, c'est possible, des extraterrestres. Fiona, Adam, c'est le meilleur endroit pour fêter mon anniversaire. C'est vrai. Est-ce qu'on ne peut pas allumer... Est-ce qu'on peut allumer... Ça, c'est une bonne question. Peut-on allumer une bougie sur la Lune? Ça, c'est une question. Ensuite, Brainwash, c'était le meilleur endroit pour terminer sa vie. Stella, c'est le meilleur endroit pour ne rien penser et découvrir une nouvelle réalité sans gravitation. C'est vrai. Denora, c'est le meilleur endroit pour explorer la Lune. Eh oui. BCD, c'est le meilleur endroit pour faire du bruit. Ça, c'est vrai. Pas de voisins. Tranquille. Yesero, c'est le meilleur endroit pour sauter. Propos 5, c'est le meilleur endroit pour voir la Terre. Yanarte, c'est le meilleur endroit pour une révélation. Eh oui, Luciana, c'est le meilleur endroit pour s'enfuir du virus. Eh oui, Cassandra, c'est le meilleur endroit pour rencontrer des extraterrestres. Bébé Moette, c'est le meilleur endroit pour penser à la vie. Amit, c'est le meilleur endroit pour apprendre le français. Pourquoi? Je ne suis pas sûr. Lynn, c'est le meilleur endroit pour voir la Terre. Hillary, c'est le meilleur endroit pour quantifier mon poids. On a le sentiment qu'on n'est pas lourd, et ça c'est formidable pour manger des gâteaux. Shahi, c'est le meilleur endroit. Ah, c'est Mars, vous pensez? Tenzin, c'est le meilleur endroit pour les extraterrestres. Cheryline, c'est le meilleur endroit pour établir un centre de perte de poids. Oui, à la fois en raison de la gravité zéro et de l'atrophie musculaire qui en résulte. C'est peut-être ça l'avenir. L'avenir de la perte de poids. Eh oui, sur la Lune. Allez. So I was thinking about that, and then I decided to for this lesson to combine, in fact, the dictation exercise that Stella was waiting for. So now it's your time, Stella, and some lyrics. So I decided to take one song from Etienne Dao. So it's a singer that I've been introducing a few lessons before. Ouverture is a beautiful, beautiful song from Etienne Dao, and so I thought it might be interesting just to work on the lyrics while doing this dictation. So I guess we'll have four or five sentences. I tried to combine them. So let's start with the first thing. Alors attention, attention. On y va, and after that, if you want, I mean, you can definitely listen to the song, which is extremely beautiful. On y va, I will read it twice, as usual. I'm looking if everything is going fine. Oui. Il n'est pas de hasard. Il n'est pas de hasard. Write the sentence. Thank you. Alors, je regarde. Well, it's quite good, in fact. Remember that, well, Azar, you will have to write it with a S in French. We don't put Z. So this is probably the only thing that was difficult for you, because for the rest, it was quite good. Hein? Il n'est pas, so in that case, it's the negative form of être, N apostrophe E-S-T. Il n'est pas de hasard, d'accord? So you can see the translation beneath. Numéro 2. Allez, same thing here. It will be a bit... No, it's not long. It's not long, in fact. No, because it's the beginner. I didn't want to have long things. Il est des rendez-vous. Il est des rendez-vous. Write the sentence. Alors, oui, effectivement, Tenzin qui dit, be careful, Tenzin, because you must remember that il can be also used for this impersonal concept. So, il is not always translated by he. This is extremely important, and in this case, it's a good example. Il doesn't mean he at all. We're talking about the impersonal form, so il est des rendez-vous will be translated by there are appointments. So, il est des rendez-vous. This one was normally quite simple. Be careful to put des rendez-vous. It should be definitely in the plural form. If it was the masculine, I would pronounce de. But in that case, it was clearly des. So, des should be written des. Il est des rendez-vous, d'accord? Let's continue. Numéro 3, allez. So it will be in the infinitive. Hein? It's just my tip. The verb will be in the infinitive because I am a nice person. Aller vers son destin. Aller vers son destin. Allez-y. Alors, Tachi, je suis rendez-vous, is it right? Not at all. No, be careful, because Tachi, we are talking about impersonal form in that situation. Impersonal, so it means that if you want to use it for yourself, it's I have, like in English, I have a meeting, I have a rendez-vous. In that case, j'ai un rendez-vous. It's the same structure, be careful. Alors, Julia, well, because it's the decision, and that's the concept, it's the decision of the artist to write it like that. So you can say, il y a des rendez-vous. If you say, il est des rendez-vous, it's a bit more delicate, and it's a bit more nice in a way. And that's his decision. So it's not my decision, it's his decision. And we're talking about a song in that case. Alors, let's have a look. As I said, it was in the infinitive, so aller should be written A-L-L-E. R, infinitive. Vers, remember that it's with the S, V-E-R-S. Son, because it's masculine. Destin, you write it, D-E-S-T-I-N. Aller vers son destin. Numéro 4, ça continue. Still the same song. Attention. J'arrive au rendez-vous dans l'épaisse fumée. J'arrive au rendez-vous dans l'épaisse fumée. Write the sentence. « Alors, two questions, Tashi. Then why il est des rendez-vous? As I explained, Tashi, this is what we call impersonal form. So you, if you're not aware or if it's not something that you master or you understand, have a look. I've been making some videos with this impersonal form and you should have a look at it. This is the reason why. It means that this is one way to express the il est, and il in that case will be, definitely translated by it, be careful. Sherilyn is asking, when a word like je or de directly precedes a word starting with H, is it always retained? Unfortunately, Sherilyn, no, because we've got two types of H. We've got H muet and H aspiré. And this is the reason why, in some cases, you will drop it, and in other cases, you will keep it. Like, for instance, if you think about words like all, that is coming from English, le all, you keep it. If you're thinking about other words like, well, ice hockey, hockey sur glace, same thing, you will keep it. So it's a bit tricky. Same thing, I've been making some list of H muet, H aspiré. Just need to remember them by heart, and this is the way it goes. Allez, j'arrive au rendez-vous dans l'épaisse fumée. So in that case, you've got the verb arriver in the present. So j'arrive, after that, au rendez-vous. So this one is not really tricky. Dans, D-A-N-S, and I'm looking at that. L'épaisse, you need to be careful, because in that case, it's an adjective. The adjective is the feminine form of épais, because the word fumée is a feminine word. So épaisse should be definitely in the feminine. L'épaisse fumée. J'arrive au rendez-vous dans l'épaisse fumée. Allez, let's have a look at numéro 5, and it's the last one. Je m'avance et je vois que tu viens comme moi d'une planète invisible. Je m'avance et je vois que tu viens comme moi d'une planète invisible. Allez-y. Bébé Moed, j'ai pensé que la phrase was about smoked fish. It's really nice, especially Bébé Moed. It's supposed to be a really romantic song. And squeezing a smoked fish in this romantic song would be extremely interesting. Why not? Allez, let's have a look at the last sentence from this song. So, je m'avance. The verb is s'avancer, so it's a reflexive verb or pronominal verb. So, in that case, you need to definitely put the pronoun me, but of course, you drop the e, and you put the apostrophe. Je m'avance. Et je vois. So the verb in that case, it's voir. Remember that you have to conjugate it in the present. And the present will go V-O-I-S. Je vois. Que tu viens. Another tricky verb. The verb venir. Still the third group. Je viens. V-I-E-N-S. Comme moi. So this one is not really difficult. D'une planète, remember that planète is feminine, so only one T, don't put two, no, one, and then it's with accent grave on the first E. Invisible is the adjective that comes right after. Je m'avance et je vois que tu viens comme moi d'une planète invisible. Voilà. And ice cubes, smoked fish. Yumi. It's supposed to be a really romantic song. And you are talking about smoked fish. Ça n'est pas raisonnable. Ça n'est pas raisonnable. Allez, voilà, c'est la fin. So it's the end for today. Remember that tomorrow it will be exactly at the same time. So, and it will be for intermediate. And we'll do it in French, only in French. Youpi! Yeah. I hope you had some fun. At least it was nice for me. Thank you very much. Bonne journée, bonne nuit, bonne soirée. Et à demain. Au revoir.